is Shanti Kumari, and I do mock interviews support also for the IT working professionals. If they have some knowledge, basic knowledge, or a little bit more than basic knowledge, I can push them for doing some mock interviews with reference to the job descriptions for DevOps and cloud roles. Here are the my services mentioned in the slide. Now, if you are appearing for cloud engineer or solution architect, or AWS DevOps and AWS SysOps, or would like to get ready for any of the roles related to the DevOps and cloud roles, we do mock interviews. Depends on your profile. Let us say profile X has got some n number of skills, and there is a JD job description. What we are going to do, we are going to walk through your profile. What are your realistic skills, and what are the gaps between the required JD and this one? We are going to identify the gaps. Then how to fulfill those gaps to appear for the interview? I'm going to advise you need to study these are the additional skills and cope up for the interviews. Even if you bring some more JDs, I don't mind giving support for discussion on that JDs also. But whatever JDs you are taking it, in the first round itself, we're going to identify the gaps within the profile with reference to one JD. Then next JD also will have some gaps, because each JD differs for the same role. If you take a cloud engineer, the cloud engineer role can be different from one company to another company. Some people involve automation with infrastructure automation with Terraform or CloudFormation, or only manual infrastructure laying down in the cloud. Such kind of variations are there. And also some people will involve DevOps tasks also in the cloud engineer role. Such kind of variations are there. And when you talk about solution architect also, there will be variations. And DevOps also, there will be variations. So all these, it varies from one JD to another JD. So if you bring more JDs also, I don't mind discussing with you with reference to the profile and with reference to the JD, identify the gaps and plan for your self-learning or take some coaching or something like that. Then you have to make sure you know at least some of the subject areas before contacting us. It means your resume has got some skills, you mentioned it. Yes, 80% or more than 70% if you know them. Yes, obviously, normally many people mention so many things. Even if they know the introduction or concepts of the tools, they mention I worked on Kubernetes or something like that. But it doesn't mean like they are going to be away from the role or JD points mapping, but they need to understand what level in the jobs they are going to ask, what kind of scenarios they are going to ask. Such kind of things we are going to discuss with reference to these two parts. One is resume, another one is job description. And these are the points we are going to identify it. The gaps within the resume and the job requirements. After that, yes, you will come up with some kind of items. You need to study these things. And how you are going to study, it's all the candidate's discretion. Like if you want to go ahead with your own self-study, that is fine. Or you want to get into our courses, as next step is we're going to explain the available courses where we can build into the project level tasks in realistic way. And you will be doing POCs in that courses. So there are two types of courses. One is cloud architect, another one is DevOps architect. Up to that level, the courses are designed. And everywhere we are using the automation of the infrastructure and DevOps automation also. So cloud areas also, we have AWS, we have Azure, we have GCP also. There were students attended these areas also in the past, and they went into the jobs, cloud jobs also, non-IT people and IT people also. Now related to this topic, if you have questions, you can discuss it. Hello.
Yeah. I think I'm good with the services and I don't have any questions with that regarding that. As you said, right, just now is the CloudFormation template. Actually, we use the CloudFormation template to spin up the EC2 instances and adding the tags for it. So on basically, reason we have to do the AMA dehydration. That means we are not supposed to use the same EC2 instance for more than 90 days. So that's why we are doing the AMA dehydration for every 90 days. So we already have a Jenkins jobs
certificate. You'll be putting a watching kind of script there to watch the age of the instances.
We don't watch any kind of age, like such kind of things. We have some kind of, we'll get some kind of notification actually from cloud governance team stating that your EC2 is, cross like 90 days or about to cross 90 days, just do the rehab, something like that. We used to receive some kind of email notification from cloud governance team. And we already have Jenkins jobs, everything is set up, where the Jenkins, the GitLab, we have all the load formation.
Right. So what we'll do, Mahesh, this part is about the mock interview services. I'll disconnect this particular recording. Then later on, we'll go ahead with the next step. What to do, all those things. I'll stop the recording at this point. Okay.